I have my information wiring this Haltech to a 1UZ. I'm using a 2500 Elite. So I have 8 injector drivers. I've already gone through and I have crimped my terminals for my injectors. Now the injectors are just a solenoid. You can have them either way round, they're not polarity specific. However, I just try to make sure all of mine are the same. And in fact, Toyota actually changed their wiring positive and negative partway through the model ranges. Now there's different resistances. That's what we talk about, impedance. So it's important to have that correct for the ECU that you're using. Now I had a guy contact me this morning and he said he thought he might use a Haltech instead of a Link because it was easier. This information crosses over to any ECU. Doesn't matter whether it's Haltech, Link, Motec, AEM. They're all the same principles apply. In fact, I could use this loom for many, many different ECUs. I have wired it. This one is in sequential injection, so that's going to make a big difference to the way that the wiring is done as the injector grouping. And it comes down to the amount of injector drives that you have. Generally, if I'm boosting, I like to have proper knock control, and I like sequential injection if the vehicle's getting boosted. And this is cool because I can just lift the loom over like this. Beauty. And this is probably the biggest difference, immediate difference in ECUs, is the number of injector drivers, the number of ignition drivers, and the number of outputs. I've chosen the 2500 in this case because I wanted sequential injection, but also because I wanted to be able to run the transmission, so I needed the outputs and the software. And that is why it was chosen. So it's important to choose an ECU that will do the job that you are trying to achieve. Right, that's the injectors just about done. This is the last one going in now. And then we'll slam them into the ECU. If you're running the likes of a 550, which will make the engine run fine if it was NA, you may want to do you want to group the injectors, because you've only got 4 drivers. But I do like the idea of sequential if I can have it. With the injectors all put together and all the terminals on, it's time to pop into the ECU. The other side of the injector gets voltage, it's 12 volts, coming from the injector or injection relay. Injector, let's see, we go down 19, 18, 19, okay, good. And I just match the color that I've written down. Pop it into A19 as the first one. A20. And they're really, really straightforward. I just match my colors. Or if again, if you're using a pre-terminated loom, you're only going to be doing the other end. You're only going to be connecting onto that injector. So it's really, really simple. Power to one side of the injector, the driver on the other. These are wired in cylinder order. So number one injector to number one drive. I know that sounds funny, and it sounds funny to be saying that, but some of the older ECUs, the ECU wasn't clever enough to work out. I've got that wrong. That's meant to be white, yellow. Trying to do two things at once, guys, not always ideal. If you get it wrong, just pop it out, put it in the right hole. Some of the older ECUs, as I was saying, they weren't clever enough to work out firing order. So you had to wire the injectors in the firing sequence. But most of the ones these days, you wire to the number one injector to number one cylinder. Oh, my dog's going to get into something. Right, that's injectors done. I'll be coming back later and doing the relay setup. I may or may not be showing that. You need a good 12 volt supply to your injectors. I think I need some ignition, some coils. We'll see you in the next one.